Hello and welcome to this UniTaster On Demand event today. My name is John Cheek. I'm here from UniTasterDays and it's my job to introduce the event and introduce the speaker. The subject we're going to be looking at today is adult nursing, and I'm absolutely delighted to be joined by Dr. Rebecca Dickinson from the University of Leeds. Rebecca is a senior lecturer in adult nursing and is going to cover things like why you might want to consider studying adult nursing, what to expect on the course if you do study it, maybe a few application tips and an overview of potential careers as well. But with that, I'll pass things over to Dr. Rebecca Dickinson, joining us from the University of Leeds.
Thank you very much for that introduction, John. Just to reiterate, my name is Rebecca Dickinson. I am a lecturer in nursing. I teach nursing at the University of Leeds and I'm a registered general nurse. And I'm going to talk to you today a little bit about what to expect if you want to come and study nursing, adult nursing. So this presentation, I'm going to go through why you might want to study adult nursing. I'm going to give you a little bit of an introduction to the adult nursing role. I'm going to talk about what it's like studying adult nursing at university and then give you some tips on applying for adult nursing. So adult nursing is quite a broad profession. We work with clients and patients from across the adult age range. We work in a patient-centered way, working in partnership with the adult and with their family. We also work in multiple different areas in the healthcare sector. So this can include the acute sector, such as providing hospital care, community care, end-of-life care, and as well as working in other private and independent organisations, for example, prison services, hospices, nursing homes, and private hospitals. Nursing is a very challenging but also a very rewarding profession. I'm sure you can appreciate that recently there's been a lot of challenges in nursing working amidst a global pandemic. And we've had to rise to those challenges, but we do get a tremendous amount of reward from working with people. We play a vital role in providing, leading and coordinating care that is compassionate, it's evidence-based and it's person-centred. We contribute to the promotion of health and well-being. And it's not just supporting people when they become unwell. What we aim to do is try and prevent people from getting disease in the first place. And we engage in empowering people, communities, populations to take control of their own health decisions and behaviours. We also provide leadership in the delivery of care for people of all ages and from different backgrounds, cultures and beliefs. So we work very carefully to be inclusive, non-judgmental, to support a whole range of different people. We also provide care for people who have complex mental, physical, cognitive and behavioural care needs. We work closely with those living with dementia, the older population, and we work with people at the end of their life within and across a whole range of different settings. If you're interested in nursing, then you need to think about some of the characteristics that are required for you to be an effective nurse. Nurses need to be accountable. We are responsible and accountable for our own practice, and we have to develop attributes such as courage and candor. We work autonomously, and sometimes we work as equal partners with a range of other professionals. We work with people at very challenging times of their life, and in order to be able to support people, we need to be emotionally intelligent and resilient individuals. We need to be able to manage our own personal health and well-being so that we can better support the patients in our care. We also have to work in the context of continual change. The healthcare profession is a fast-paced, fast-moving area to work in, and it can be very challenging. We have to work within different models of care delivery. There are shifting demographics. There's constant innovation in the healthcare field. And there's rapidly evolving technologies that we need to be able to adapt and use so that we can provide optimal and effective care for our patients. It's a really exciting area to come and work in, but very fast paced, and you have to be prepared to adapt to change. Nurses need to negotiate boundaries, and we play a proactive role in interdisciplinary teams. We also have to be very confident. We have to have the ability to think critically, apply knowledge and skills, and provide expert, evidence-based and direct nursing care. So we've got a whole range of skills that we need to be able to apply to make sure that we're effectively supporting patient care. Nursing is a regulated profession. We are regulated by the NMC, the Nursing and Midwifery Council, and they set the standards for proficiency for nursing. If you are going to come and study nursing, you will be expected to develop proficiency in the following areas: being an accountable professional, promoting health and preventing ill health, assessing needs and planning care, providing and evaluating care, leading and managing nursing care and working in teams, improving safety and quality of care, coordinating care, communication and relationship management skills, and in developing skills in doing nursing procedures. So I'm going to talk about those a little bit more. So you will be expected to develop a whole range of different clinical skills as you come into nursing, and these will develop in increasing complexity as you progress through the course. The new NMC Future Nurse Standards develops a wider range of skills that nurses are expected to learn and develop. So this includes things like cannulation, taking blood, doing a 12-lead ECG, chest auscultation, and also you'll be expected to be prescriber ready at qualification. So this means that you will have a depth of knowledge about supporting patients to manage their medicines effectively and optimally. So and there's a great deal more skills that nurses need to have as well. So there's lots and lots that you can learn about during your time studying adult nursing. So nurses work as part of the multidisciplinary team, and we will work with a range of different professions. There's some examples in the box here. So you can see we'll work alongside doctors, physios, occupational therapists, radiographers, porters, cleaners, social workers, pharmacists, advanced clinical practitioners. And this list is not, you know, there's plenty more examples of other professions we'll work with. We all pull together to provide effective care for the patient. And we don't just work with people when they're unwell. We also work in holistic health promoting ways to protect health and well-being and prevent the worsening of illness and disease. If you do come study nursing at university, you will leave with having a professional and an academic qualification. So that means not only will you go away with a degree, you will also go away with the ability to register with the NMC, our regulatory body, and practice as a nurse in the UK. You do need to be aware that nursing can be quite an intensive programme. It is a 3-year programme, and sometimes it requires a little bit more hours and study than some other undergraduate degree choices. And the reason for this is because nursing has half of its time spent in the classroom and the other half spent out on clinical practice, clinical placement, where you will be working alongside healthcare practitioners, particularly nurses, to develop your skills and provide real life care to real life people in a real life clinical environment. And that's a really interesting and exciting draw into studying nursing, because you will get that hands-on, on-the-job experience. You'll also be studying to develop your skills and knowledge about nursing a whole range of different topics. You'll be studying biology and pathophysiology. This helps you develop your depth of knowledge about how disease manifests and how it presents itself with patients and how we can manage and support their health outcomes. You'll also learn about sociology, psychology, and ethics. You'll develop your knowledge of clinical skills. You'll learn about how research and evidence-based practice underpins nursing practice. You will develop your skills in leadership and management, and you will develop enhanced advanced skills in communication, plus much, much more. Nursing is a broad profession, and we require a great degree of knowledge to fit into our nursing toolkit, so we can adapt and better provide support to the patients who we provide care for. If you do come study nursing, you might experience learning in a whole range of different environments. The picture that's on this slide is the picture of the clinical skills lab that we have at Leeds University. And you will find that there are clinical skills labs in many other institutions as well. So in order to develop your clinical skills, you may find that you're learning in a clinical skills laboratory or another simulated care facility. And these are areas where you can develop your skills and prepare for your placements in a safe and well-equipped environment. You'll also engage with some learning online. So you'll have access to online teaching sessions using a range of other platforms, and you'll have access to online books, articles, and other resources. But what really is a big draw for coming and studying nursing is that ability to engage in real-world practice. So you'll have practice learning opportunities within local healthcare providers, and this will include both hospital and community settings, as well as other local caring environments. So I'll tell you a little bit more about the real world practice that you might experience. All student nurses will be expected to have placements in 5 different placement environments. So you'll expect to go on a medical placement, a surgical placement, an older adult placement, a critical care placement, and a community placement. And this gives you a real depth and breadth of understanding about what clinical care looks like in a real world environment. I'm going to give you a few examples of the placement locations that we have access to in Leeds. If you're interested in applying to other institutions, you might want to do a bit of research about the type of placement locations they can offer. It may vary from region to region. Different regions will provide different clinical specialisms. In Leeds, we have access to Leeds Teaching Hospitals Trust. So that's a large range of different hospitals, which also provide a lot of different centre of excellent care environments, including Leeds Cancer Centre, Leeds Cardiac Centre, Leeds Major Trauma Centre, Leeds Rheumatology Service. So these are real clinical specialisms that you may experience placements within. We also have access to Leeds Community Healthcare NHS Trust. So you may be able to travel anywhere within a Leeds postcode area to see what care has been provided out in the community. And just to let you know, if you are interested in coming and studying adult nursing, you may need to be prepared to travel. Some of your placements may be located a little bit away from where the body of study is. And there will be an expectation that you will do some shift work. Nursing is a 24-hour profession, so do be prepared for that. We also have placements with out in the community with health visitors, practice nurses, community nurses, and school nurses. And we have a range of different private, independent, and voluntary organisations we can access for placements as well, including nursing homes, private hospitals, hospices, and prisons. So all in all, you can see there's a whole variety of different clinical settings in which you will experience a healthcare placement in, develop your nursing skills and expertise. And throughout your time out on placement as well, you will be supported by a practice assessor or a practice supervisor who will support you to develop your skills and proficiencies as you're going along through the programme. So you've always got somebody who's a good point of sort of support when you're out in practice learning these skills. So if you want to apply for adult nursing, you can apply through UCAS in year 13. The deadline is the last Wednesday in January. We will look at your GCSEs and predicted level 3 grades. So typically there's 5 GCSEs, grade C or above, or grade 4 or 5, including maths and English plus science. We would also review the A levels that you have, but there are also other similar qualifications, for example, access to higher education diplomas and BTECs, for example. There's a variety of different routes for coming into nursing, so please do contact the admissions department at the institution that you're interested in to find out more about this. You've got 5 different university choices that you can put down, and your application will be accompanied by a personal statement. So what we want to see is, in your personal statement, you explain why it is you want to do adult nursing specifically. There are other fields of nursing, but we're interested in why it's adult nursing in particular that you're interested in. We want to see, have you got any knowledge or understanding about the profession? What is it that motivates you to be interested in studying adult nursing? We also want to see what skills that you might have that are required by nurses, and what you might do in your spare time. And that's quite important, because what we're trying to think about is, what are those transferable skills that you might have learned from various different hobbies or sports teams, for example, or the employment that you might have engaged in? What are those transferable skills that apply to nursing? When a decision has been made, you may be invited to an interview between November and March. So that gives you a bit of an idea about applying to study nursing. There's a lot of different support for aspiring nurses out there. So there's a whole host of various resources available online. So you can engage in online webinars and workshops about healthcare and nursing. You can undertake a MOOC, an online course about healthcare and nursing. You may have the opportunity to dip into some taster days and summer schools in 2022. Of course, this is COVID dependent. Some local NHS trusts will hold summer schools to try and entice people into learning more about healthcare and different careers in healthcare, in particular nursing. You can contact local NHS trusts about work experience and any shadowing opportunities that they may offer. And you can also research and contact specific universities for their work experience requirements. We do understand it's been a bit more challenging in recent years for students to have work experience in healthcare. But what we really want to see is that you can think about the transferable skills from other parts of your life that might apply to nursing and that meet the criteria of what is expected of an adult nurse. There is some financial support for healthcare students. So there are some new annual payments of at least £5,000 for all eligible undergraduate students on specific healthcare courses. There's also additional funding for some specialist subject areas and childcare costs where recruitment is particularly hard. And this is all in addition to support from maintenance loans and bursaries and grants from individual institutions. So if you want to find out more about that, have a look at the NHS Learning Support Fund and you'll find more information. And that brings us to talking about a lifetime career in nursing. It is a lifetime career and a wonderful opportunity. We do find that most of our students find employment upon graduation because nurses are in demand. So on completion of the course, many of our students will have already found a job that they want to go to. And there are definitely many different opportunities that you can pursue. So once you've qualified, you could work in a hospital or a community care-based setting. You can go on to become a clinical specialist. You can be a prescriber. You can work in management, research and education. You can use your nursing qualification to work overseas. British nurses are in high demand due to the standards of our education. And you can also engage in further study. And this can include things such as advanced clinical practice courses, independent and supplementary prescribing courses, as well as master's or doctorate level study. It really is a lifelong career that will change your life. Thank you very much for listening to me today.